In this video, we are going to see about variables and arithmetic operation in Python. First, let's see variable. Variable is a placeholder for any value. For example, if you want to store some values like 10, 20, or you want to store some names, then you should have a placeholder. These placeholders are called variables. You don't have to declare a variable as int or char as you do in other languages like C or Java. Here you can see price equal to 20. Price is a variable of type int which holds the value 20. Price underscore new is a variable of type float which has the value 10.5. Name is a variable of type string. For strings, you need to specify single quotes or double quotes as shown here. While using a variable, we need to take care of few things. First one is, variables are case sensitive. That is, price which starts with capital letter and price which starts with small letter are different. Second thing is, variables should start with letters. You can have numbers in between, but you should not start a variable with number. Finally, underscores are allowed in variable name. Next, we will see operations. Python supports all these arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, exponent, and modulo. This is addition. Here, 1 plus 2 gives 3, and this is multiplication, 10 into 2, 20. These are simple and you know already. This is exponent. So this is same as 2 to the power of 2, which is equal to 4. Now if I give 2 to the power of 3, that is 8. Now this one is modulo operator. It prints the remainder after division. For example, here 3 modulo 2, that is when you divide 3 by 2, you have the remainder 1. So you will get the result as 1 for 3 modulo 2. Now in this example, what we are doing is, we have assigned the values to variables, that is A equal to 10 and B equal to 20. So we have two variables here, A and B. Now you add these two variables and assign the result to sum. And we are printing the sum. Now here, in the similar way, we are finding the power, that is A to the power of B, and we are getting 1000 as the result. Now let's see the division operator, 8 divided by 2. Here the result is 4.0, that is a floating point number. Division returns a floating point number. Now if I give 8.2 divided by 2, the result is 4.1. Now if we are using 2 slash instead of 1 slash, then the decimal part will be removed. For example, here 8.2 by 2, we are using 2 slash, then the result will be 4.0 instead of 4.1. The decimal part is removed. Here we will see what will be the result when you add an integer with a floating point number. The result will be a floating point number. So by this, I am concluding this video. Thank you for watching.